We made this video to help you navigate the CMMI travel process and CONCUR CGE travel system. Please note that before you begin entering in travel and authorizations in CONCUR, your trip should be on your group quarterly travel plan. Please make sure to check with your supervisor. Let's dive right in. First and foremost, reach out to Cheryl Church or Eva Gazinski prior to CONCUR entry so you can retrieve the appropriate CAN number that you will need to enter in CONCUR. Also, please keep in mind that if you see any pop-up windows in CONCUR asking you for to accept a fee, do not accept it without consulting with your travel team. If you do select accept, you will be responsible for paying these fees. Any fees associated with your trip are already embedded in CONCUR and are fully reimbursable by the government. Let's go ahead and get started in CONCUR. Select the e-travel button from the HHS homepage. If you don't have this link, it's because you don't have a CONCUR profile. If you do not have a CONCUR profile, please contact Eva or Cheryl immediately and we can set you up with an account. A window with the Privacy Act will pop up. Go ahead and select Agree. The first thing you'll need to do is review your profile in the top right corner. Click Profile. Do not select Save at the end of each section. You will receive an error report stating these are the blank fields within the profile. Please wait until you have entered all information before clicking Save at the bottom. Here you can check your personal information to make sure everything is okay. The first section is for your expense information. You will want to make sure the org is designated HHSFCP. Note, CMMI only has one routing list, which is designated FCP-TDY. If you do not have a government credit card, then you would pick Advanced Authorize. If you are a government credit card holder, then you would select Card Holder. For entitlement, under Entitlement Rules, you will select Default to FTR. If you're a commissioned corps, you will need to reach out to Cheryl or Eva to change your status to JTR. For long-term taxable travel, we leave this section blank. Agency information, leave as is. For duty station address, please make sure you fill this information out. For the street, we will use the 7500 address and your desk location for mail stop. For home address, please fill out the relevant information. For the contact information, please make sure it is filled out and accurate. Emergency contact, please fill out your emergency contact information in this field. For travel preferences, we always have to select government. You can continue to pick your own personal preferences for seat accommodation and hotel preferences as well. However, these two sections are optional. All your frequent flyer travel numbers, rental car information, driver information, etc., can all go in the frequent travel program section. You can skip the ticket credit sections. However, the TSA secure flight information is very important. Please go ahead and fill out the necessary relevant fields. If you have a TSA pre-check number, this is a section in which you would enter this information. For international travel, this section will not be applicable unless you're going on international travel. If you're going on international travel, please go ahead and fill out this section. For assistance travel arranger section, you will enter the name of your travel preparer. If you do not have one, you can leave this section blank. If you select the refuse self-assigning assistance checkbox, no one will be able to assist you with your travel or vouchers. Therefore, we recommend not check this box. If you have a travel preparer, then select Add Assistant. Type in the individual's name and select Can Book Travel For Me. This takes you to the credit card section at the very bottom. It is very important to check to make sure the credit card information has rolled over properly from the previous system. Please review the credit card information and make sure the information is correct. If not correct, please go ahead and delete and re-enter the information. In order to book a hotel or rental car, you must have at least one credit card on file. After all information has been entered in the profile, go to the bottom and click Save. This brings you to the home page. It is important to know that you make your reservations first and then your authorization once the reservation has been made. To make a reservation, go to Travel tab. Your system should automatically default to New Authorization from the Travel tab, and the system defaults to Round Trip as well. Here you will select your reference point. For the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to select reference point and use address 233 South Wacker Drive in Chicago, Illinois. From here, you go down to Departure City and click on the necessary field. You will notice that the three airports that we are authorized to use pop up. You can select both of the departure location and the return location for this section. Select your appropriate departure time and return time, and select pick up, drop off car at airport and hotel. It is not standard practice to get a rental car. However, for the purpose of this tutorial, we select car. You can also filter your hotel options by selecting airport, address, agency location, or zip code. Click search, and this brings you to the flight page. As you can see, these are the results based off the search. We will go ahead and select government contract discounted fares. The only time the non-contract government can be used is if you present some type of justification. For the purposes of this tutorial, we will be selecting government contract discounted. Click government contract discounted. Here you will be able to view the options based off the search. It's important to choose the lowest price or options based off the result. Please make sure your sorted by field is under policy most compliant. You can also filter your airport filters by going to the right-hand side of the screen and selecting departure and arrival locations for both the outbound and return. Go ahead and select best option by clicking the green button that says fares. Scroll down to the manila colored box and select the government contract discounted, refundable. You can also select your frequent flyer points by selecting this drop-down bar here. Please keep in mind that this would need to be reflected in your profile in order to exercise the flyer points. Go ahead and select the green reserve button. On the screen, make sure that the credit card is selected. Then click Next. On the top screen, you will see the GSA regulations. Scroll down and you will see the rental car options and select the economy car column. Scroll down and choose the best economically sound option. Then click the green reserve button. This will bring you to the hotel page. Scroll down and select the option that fits government per diem. The manila box will list the price for the government per diem. After you've picked your hotel, select choose room and the different room options will appear. Choose one of the green options. After you've selected the room, click the reserve button. If everything looks okay, select the I agree button and hit continue. Please go ahead and select the appropriate credit card and click the reserve hotel on the bottom of the page. Here, you will see the itinerary appear. If everything looks okay, then go ahead and select next on the bottom of the page. This should bring you to the trip booking information. Go ahead and enter a description. Here you'll be identifying the purpose of this trip. For example, accountable care organizations, name of meeting venue, and complete street address for your trip. You can also print or email the itinerary. Scroll down and select Next. Your itinerary will appear one last time. Again, if everything looks correct, go ahead and select Confirm Bookings. This will take you to the authorization page. Scroll down and you will see a reservation has already been populated. Go ahead and select Next. Your document type, document name, document date, tandem, and trip name will be populated. Type code should be single trip, and select the purpose which is applicable to you. Please enter some information in the document detail if you would like to update. After you have entered this information, go ahead and select Save Changes, and then click Next. Double check to make sure you have to click Save Changes. Scroll down to Expense Details, and you will see this is where you will enter all of your trip expenses. For example, taxi fees, shuttle, hotel taxes, parking, gasoline for car. This is where you will place all potential expenses you may incur. To add an expense, select Add Expense, and a window will appear on the right-hand side of your screen. Select Expense Description, and you select what is applicable to you. You would choose a date, or if it is for your whole trip, select the Create Expense through option. Click Save and repeat this process until you have accumulated all of your expenses. Let's go ahead and add a few expenses for our trip. If you plan on using leave while on travel, you would do the following. First, click on the pen and pencil on the MNIE on the day of leave. Then select Show Per Diem Conditions. Click on Leave, then Save. Now it has taken us out of the MNIE and zeroed out the hotel costs. Now you need to remove any expenses on the day of leave. For example, hotel tax and any one day of parking that may have been added. To do so, you will click the checkbox in the Delete column and click Delete, select Expenses. Please do not try and delete the MNIE costs. Then we will go ahead and select the cost and payment method. The payment method will be either personal or IBA. If you have an IBA, you must use this credit card for all TDY travel expenses. Choose what is applicable to you. Click Save and you can continue to add expense descriptions if need be. After you've added all the expenses, go ahead and select Next. This will take you to the accounting page. Go ahead and select New Account Code. The accounting field will be left as is. You can put any name in the label field. However, it is important to enter something in this field or an error will pop up. Fiscal year should be applicable to the fiscal year you are in. The sponsored box can be left blank. Select the correct fiscal year on the Next tab. Go to the CAN section, select the icon to the right, binoculars, and search for the CAN number given to you by Cheryl or Eva. After you have entered the correct CAN, repeat the same process for searching for your object class code or OCC number. Most of the time, your object class code will fall under a conference or site visit. For the purposes of this tutorial, we are going to select Site Visit Program Domestic. It's the first option. After the fields have been filled, select Add to Document. Your accounting line item will appear here. Go ahead and click Next. This will take you to the Advances page, and go ahead and select Next. Now we are at the Exceptions page. If any of the exceptions apply to you, the system will be looking for a justification. Select your justification and click Next. If you don't have a justification, go ahead and select Next. This will take you back to the Profile page. Confirm everything looks correct and select Next. You are now at the Totals page. This page will give you an expense summary for each category in your trip. If everything looks okay, select Next. Now you're at the Perform Pre Audits page. Select Justify Pre Audits Results. This is currently a glitch in the CONCUR system. In order for you to request go through, you will need to enter something in the Pre Audit Fail fields in order to move forward. Something as simple as disregard will be suffice to move forward. You can ignore all of the pass fields. Click Save Justifications after you've entered all the relevant fields, and go ahead and select Next. If you receive a status that says hard fail, please reach out to Cheryl and Eva. This brings you to the confirmation page. The status to apply field should read signed. The reason field, remarks field, and return to field should be left blank. If everything looks okay, click the stamp and submit document button. This will send you back to the Perform Pre-Audits tab. Hit Continue Stamping Document. You will see the status has failed. However, this is okay due to glitches in the system. Your FADIS will be able to determine that your request is actually not in a failed state. Go ahead and select Continue Stamping the Document. Click Close and Stamp Document and your request has been submitted. When you have received your itinerary, you will know that you have completed the process in CONCUR. Give yourself a pat on the back. The next step in the travel process is for your CMMI FADIS, Eva and Cheryl, to check your submission and CONCUR and Fund Certify. If we see any issues in your documentation or submission, we will reach out to you and help you resolve it in CONCUR. Thanks for having patience with the process. There are many rules regarding federal travel, and we really appreciate your efforts in learning those rules. We are here to help you.